So junction of resistors and capacitors. Again, select this place wire and junction of resistors.
Sir, one nimsha. Heli sir, mathe heli sir.
Select this wire, okay? Place wire. Mm-hmm. And then from third pin to junction of two resistors. Junction of two resistors. And press escape. Fine? And one more power supply, right? VDC. Select this place part. VDC type, VDC. Okay? You'll get this. See this one. Click on OK. And place one VDC here. And place one V reference here. Okay? Escape. You can even see. We don't have enough space, right? So you can extend this. Select this resistor and extend it. Like this. Okay, select this resistor and extend like this. Okay. So next, select this VDC, place it here. Okay. Later we'll rotate it. So now, which is plus 12 and which is minus 12? That is the question. 7th pin is plus 12 and 4th pin is minus 12. But here, while giving the value, you just select, double click on this, type 12. Okay. And select this 0 VDC and type 12. Okay. Now 12, both are 12. Now which is plus 12 and which is minus 12? 7th pin. 7th pin plus 12, right? So now let me make the connection. First I'll finish this connection. Connect this positive end to, okay, first one. Before making the connection. So from ground, I'll extend. Okay, let me extend this line. Escape that. So place ground, place fourth option. Fourth icon is place net alias, that is for ground. And type 0, click on OK. And place one ground here. You cannot place ground like this. See, it has to be at the top. Like this, fine. So now, which is, now still I have not made these connections, right? Okay. KVL, Kirchhoff's voltage now. So apply KVL from ground towards 7 for, this is op amp, right? 7 for 1 op amp. Apply KVL from ground towards op amp. Okay. So if I apply KVL, which is, what is the opposite sign?
Minus.
So fourth pin is minus 12. And if I place, what is that? If I trace this from ground towards op amp, what is the opposite sign?
Plus.
So plus 12. So that is what polarity will tell you, which is plus 12 and which is minus 12. Okay. So now you can make the connection. Fine. This one and this one. What is happening? This, that's it. And then now let us view the value. Ground. Okay. One more ground. Place net alias. Click type 0. One ground here and one ground here. And more. Done. So now let us give the values. What is the value here? Zoom in. See. Select this. This is name of the capacitor C1. Double click on this. 0.1U. 0.1U. That's it. And next. This is 5K. 5.1K or 5K. Whichever is 5. 5K. 5K. Click on OK. And then this is 10K. And this is also 10K. That's it. Yes, yes. This is the connection. Now place probe. So place probe. This is place. This, see this one. Read that. Place voltage or level marker. Voltage or level marker. Select this and place one input probe. This capacitor, not input. Capacitor. Output, this is capacitor output and this is this one rectangle square output. Capacitor output and square output, fine. And press escape. So now go to simulation settings. New simulation profile. And give some random name. You can give any name. Create and then run to time. What is run to time? Run to time can be 10 milliseconds, 20 milliseconds, 30 milliseconds. Okay. I'll take 20 milliseconds. And this one maximum steps is 0.1 millisecond. 0.1 m. That's enough. Click on OK and now click on run. So this is the output. Now color will change. Green is capacitor output and red is square output. So green is capacitor output, right? This is rectangular waveform. Okay. If I change the value of this one, go to edit. If you want to change run to time and maximum step size, go to edit simulation set profile settings, and here you can change it from 20 millisecond to 30 millisecond, or as 10 millisecond better, 10 millisecond and 0.1 maximum step distance. Okay, and again click on run. So now see this, it is not visible, right? So that is why, just to make adjustment. Okay, edit simulation profile and make it 30 millisecond. Click on OK. So what will happen now? See, you will see more cycles. Okay, but the frequency will be same.